हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू येट अनदर वीडियो सेशन ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स फॉर ग्रेड 6. दिस इज़ फॉर चैप्टर 3 एंड वी आर गोइंग टू अंडरस्टैंड द डिविजिबिलिटी रूल. सो वॉट एक्चुअली इज द डिविजिबिलिटी रूल. सो डिविजिबिलिटी रूल आर एक्चुअली द सेट ऑफ रूल्स दैट टेल यू इफ अ गिवन नंबर इज डिविजिबल बाय अनदर नंबर और नॉट विदाउट एक्चुअली कैरिंग आउट द डिविजन. You understand that we actually don't carry out the division, but we come to know if a given number is actually divisible by a number or not, and that is called as divisibility rule. We have divisibility rule all the way from 2 till 12, and we are going to study each one of them one by one. So let's move ahead. The first one is divisibility rule for 2. A number is divisible by 2 if its last digit is even digit. As you can see, if the last digit is even digit, we can say that the number is divisible by 2. We have couple of examples. Example 296 is divisible by 2. Why? Because the last digit is an even number. Same way, if we take 174, we can clearly say that this number is divisible by 2. Why? Again, because the last digit is an even number. On the other hand, if we take example 75, the last digit is 5, which is not an even number. Hence, this number is not divisible by 2. Let's take few more examples. 97. Now, can you understand and determine whether 97 is divisible by 2 or not? The last digit is an odd number or an even number? It is an odd number. So, this is not divisible by 2. Similarly, if we take the example of 128, we can clearly say that since 8 is an even number, hence 128 is divisible by 2. Yes, 128 is it's divisible by 2. Right? Let's take yet another example. Moving ahead with the divisibility rule of 3. A number is divisible by 3 if the sum of its digits is divisible by 3. So in the example 3276, if we make the sum 3 plus 2 plus 7 plus 6, that comes to 18. Now we know that 18 is divisible by 3 because 3 6 are 18, right? Similarly, if we take another example 1024, and the sum of these numbers is 1 plus 0 plus 2 plus 4, and that is equal to 7. Now 7 is certainly not divisible by 3 because 3 ke table mein 7 nahi aata, and that is the reason why we say that number 1024 is not divisible by 3, right? Let's move ahead. Understand the divisibility rule of 4. A number is divisible by 4 if the last two digits are divisible by 4. So for an example, if we take 1028, last two digit is 28, and that is certainly divisible by 4. 4 7s are 28. So yes, this number is divisible by 4. Whereas if we take another example, 42725, is the last two digit over here is 25, which is certainly not falling in the table of 4. Hence this number 42725 is not divisible by 4, right? Let's try to understand the divisibility rule of 5. So a number is divisible by 5 if the last digit is either 0 or 5. Now this is very simple, either 0 or 5 last digit. So in this example, 9475, the last number is 5. So certainly yes, this number is divisible by 5. Whereas if we take another example, 7829, the last number is neither 0 nor 5. Hence we can say that this number is not divisible by 5, right? This number is not divisible. Let's try to understand the divisibility rule for 6. So a number is divisible by 6 if it is divisible by 2 and over here it is and, okay, so keep that in mind, and it is divisible by 3 as well. So if a number is divisible by 2 and if it is divisible by 3, we can say that the given number is divisible by 6. Let's take an example. 216 is divisible by 2 because the last digit is even, right? The last digit is even over here. And if we try to take the same example, 216, is that divisible by 3 or not? So if we have to just make the sum, 2 plus 1 plus 6, and that is equal to 9. So 9 is certainly divisible by 3, and hence we can say that the number 216 is divisible by rule 6 or number 6. Okay, let's understand the divisibility rule for 7. Now, before we actually understand this, let's try to understand how it actually works. Okay, so in this we'll try to understand this by an example as well. So over here we have to take the last digit of the given number and double it. Double it ka matlab kya hota hai? Multiply by 2 kar dena hai aapko, right? Double it by multiply by 2. And then subtract it from the remaining digits. If the answer is equal to 0 or any number which is divisible by 7, then we can say that yes, rule of divisibility of 7 applies here. Let's just try to understand this by an example. I have taken the example of 413. Now over here the last digit is certainly 3, right? So humne 3 ko kya kiya? Double kiya sabse pehle. 3 to just 6 kiya, right? 3 to just 6. Now we have to subtract this 6 from the remaining number, which is 41. So we are doing 41 minus 6, and that is equal to 35. Now tell me, 7 ke table mein 35 aata hai? Yes, 7 5 is 35, and hence we can say that number 35 is divisible by 7, right? So we can say that number 413 is certainly divisible by 7, right everybody? We have yet another example, 168. Agar hum dusra example lete hain, so sabse pehle hum kya karenge, we'll just double the last number, which is 8. So yahan pe 8 to just 16 ho jata hai, right? Now if I have to subtract this 16 from the remaining digit over here, 16 minus 16, right? And that will be equal to 0. So certainly yes, rule of divisibility of 7 applies here. Okay, let's try to understand the divisibility rule for number 8. So what does this rule say? In this rule, it's very simple. You have to just remember it by the last 3 digit for any given number. If the last 3 digit is divisible by 8, then we can say that the divisibility rule of 8 applies here. Let's try to understand this by an example. So we have this number 84,136. Ab hume kya karna hai? Last 3 digit lena. We have to just take the last 3 digit, 136. Now we have to try and divide that by 8. So 8 1 ja 8, 8 7 ja 56, right? So we can clearly say that number 84,136 is divisible by 8. Let's try to take one more example, 2,417. Humne kya kiya? Last ke 3 digit liye, 417, and just try to divide that by 8. So 8 5 is a 40. I know that one will be over here. 7 8 2 ja 16, right? Again 1. Ab agar yahan pe mujhe 0 lagana hai to yahan decimal lagana hoga, which is not a complete divisible, right? So agar humne decimal laga diya, yahan pe hamara remainder 0 nahi raha hai, right? Hamara remainder jo hai, that is not a 0, right? So we can say that number 2417 is not divisible, whereas number 84,136 is divisible by the rule of 8. Cool, let's move ahead to the next divisibility rule, which is the divisibility rule for number 9. If all the digits added recursively give the answer as 9, then we can say that the number is divisible by 9. Now over here, what do you exactly mean by the word recursively? Let's try to understand this by an example. So we have this example, 74,916. Now if you just try to add all this number, जैसे कि आप divisibility rule of 3 में try करते हो ना, same वैसे ही. So 7 plus 4 plus 9 plus 1 plus 6, and that is equal to 27. Now you have to add this also, that is 2 plus 7, and that is equal to 9. If you get the answer as 9, then you can say that the divisibility rule of 9 applies here. Correct? Let's try to understand the divisibility rule of 10. It's pretty simple, very easy. If the last digit is equal to 0, then we can say that the number is divisible by 10. Over here, let's try to take this as an example, 3570. If I have taken the example 3570, we know that the last digit is 0, and hence this number is divisible by 10. Whereas if I take the example 2571, the last digit is not, over here the last digit is not 0, and hence we can say that this rule of 10 does not apply here. Alright, let's move to the next number, which is number 11. So what actually happens in this? We have to take the sum of the digit at the odd places minus sum of the digit at the even places. And if your answer is either 0 or a number which is divisible by 11, then we can say that the divisibility rule of 11 applies for the given number. Let's try to understand this by an example. I have taken the number 75,152. Right? Now, what do we have to do first? Digits at the odd places. Sum of digit at the odd places. So this is an odd number, this is odd place, this is again an odd place, this is again an odd place. So we have to just add these numbers. So 7 plus 1, 8, 8 plus 2, 10, right? So that is what we have done, 7 plus 1 plus 2, and that is equal to 10. And then you have to also take the numbers at the even places. So even place we have 5 plus 5, that is again 10. 5 plus 5, that is again 10. Now what is the difference? Over here you can see that we have difference nikala tha, right? Rule ke hisab se. And if the number has to be 0, और इट हैज़ टू बी ए नंबर विच इज़ डिविजिबल बाई 11. सो यहाँ पे हमारा क्या है, 5 प्लस 5 10 है, और ये भी हमारा 7 प्लस 1 प्लस 2 दैट इज़ इक्वल टू अगेन 10. सो वी कैन क्लियरली से दैट 10 माइनस 10 इज इक्वल टू 0, एज शोन ओवर हियर 0, राइट? सो वी कैन से दैट द नंबर 75,152 इज डिविजिबल बाई 11, राइट? लेट्स ट्राई टू टेक वन मोर एग्जाम्पल. इन दिस एग्जाम्पल 21,824, आपको सबसे पहले क्या करना है, ऑड प्लेसेस की जो नंबर है उनका सम करना, राइट? सो विल ऐड 2 प्लस 8 प्लस 4 एंड दैट इज इक्वल टू 14. एट द सेम टाइम 1 प्लस 2 करेंगे आप तो कितना आएगा, 3. दैट इज इक्वल टू 1 प्लस 2 इज इक्वल टू 3, राइट? सो इन दोनों का डिफरेंस निकालना है हमको. सो 14 माइनस 3 कितना आएगा आपका, इट हैज़ टू बी 11. नाउ एज पर द रूल, इफ द रिजल्ट इज 0 और अ नंबर divisible by 11. Now over here 11 is certainly divisible by 11. Hence we can clearly say that the number 21,824 is divisible by 11. Okay. Moving ahead to the last rule which is divisibility rule for 12. So isme kya hota hai? Again, if the number is divisible by 3 and the number has to be divisible by 4 at the same point of time. If both these conditions satisfy, अगर number 3 के साथ भी divisible है and if the number is divisible by 4 as well, then we can say that the divisibility rule of 12 applies. Let's take this by an example. We have taken the example of 5,508. Now do you think this number is divisible by, first of all 3 के साथ try करेंगे, फिर हम इसको 4 का rule apply करेंगे, ठीक है? So 3 के rule में क्या होता है, 5 plus 5 plus 0 plus 8 करेंगे हम सीधा, right? So we'll just add 5 plus 5 plus 0 plus 8 and that is equal to 5 plus 5 10, 10 plus 8 18, so which is 18, and in the table of 3 18 comes, yes or no? Of course yes, 3 6 are 18, right? So we can say that the number 5508 has passed the divisibility rule of 3. Now let's try to understand the same for the divisibility rule of 4, and we can clearly see that the last two digit over here is 8 and it is as well divisible because the last two digits are divisible by 4, 0, 8, हमारे 4 के rule के हिसाब से. Now since both the rule of 3 and the rule of 4, or the number is divisible by 3 and the number is divisible by 4, condition satisfies over here. Hence we can say that the number is divisible by 12. So the number 5508 is divisible by 12. I hope you find this video interesting at the same point of time. It's very good to learn new concepts. Keep learning. Thank you everyone once again. Thank you. Bye-bye.